important that when you're trying to fend off zombies, that you do not hit your machine. You will need your machine. Just going to clear out some zombies around me. It takes some work to ensure that the coast is clear. It helps to have a weapon that is very powerful in this case. Thus, the broadsword is a good start. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to read first magazine, going to read second magazine, going to, if I don't get bitten, read third magazine. I just read all my magazines. You don't have to read them in order. Now I'm going to clean the way. And as you can see, there's two buttons here. There's bet and bet max. I'm going to bet max. Waste $1,000. With each bet, you always, when you're doing this, have to check around you as you bet. Make sure there's no zombies approaching. That's why it helps to have a powerful weapon when you do this. There we go. Bit of money. At first, it won't seem like it's paying out a lot, right? But keep it up. I have a shirt that color. Green, not the red that I put on it. $25,000. Now, by conservative calculations, you will need to make the game tremendously easier. You will need $4 million. Now, am I saying you have to do this all at once? No. Essentially, whenever you have free time between missions, which won't be often, you're going to come and do this. What that means is that you have to keep all three magazines on you, which takes up three item slots, which can be lofty, can be heavy, especially for a new player who needs to have the availabilities of those storage spaces. Now, it should be noted that you can perform the same in you could perform the same exercise in sandbox mode. And in sandbox mode, you don't have time limits on, because you don't have missions. So you can do this to your heart's content. The problem is in sandbox mode, as mentioned, you cannot get the security key for the safety deposit box, which gives you one of the gambling magazines. So you could only use two gambling magazines in sandbox mode. What this does is this reduces the amount of time you're going to win, the frequency you're going to win, I should say, and reduces the amounts you're going to win. So performing this task with but two of the three gambling magazines takes longer. Okay, now as you can see, find Zombrex. Since I know what I'm doing, or at least I assume I do, I'm going to wait. Oh, look at my health. Time to consume. As mentioned, it helps to know where high-value items are. I'm going to show you where a high-value item is in regards to the slot machine, since you're going to be spending a lot of time here. Cross over the entrance to the food court into the bar here, the bar area. Now, in the bar area is a pizza. Pizza is high-value. Also, around here, anything else? There's also booze. Booze is any type of booze, wine, whiskey, beer, there's another pizza right there, is relatively high value. The problem with it is you cannot consume more than two drinks in a short amount of time. If you do, Frank will, or Chuck, if you're playing co-op, will uncontrollably vomit. And the last thing you want to do is when you're under the gun, so to speak, when you're surrounded by zombies and they are attacking you, is to be uncontrollably vomiting. That doesn't help anybody. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to wait till Find Zombrex goes into the red. If you are completely inexperienced with this game and you really need help orienting yourself, Perhaps this isn't a wise idea. Fine, Zombrex just went into the red. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to open up the map, and I'm going to select Find Zombrex. Did it work? You gotta take off your pointer before you select it, it would seem. Okay. As mentioned, the arrow's a little wrong. The problem, of course, is right now my sword is flashing. My sword doesn't have a lot of durability left, and I'm going to have to take on 3 thugs in this mission. However, hopefully my sword lasts the 3 attacks. In this video, I'm going to be skipping all cutscenes for the sake of time. Also, if you perform what I suggested you perform, that is, first play a first game very simply, and your goal is to just finish it as simply as possible to get enough experience points to have a fighting chance to have a full game, then what I recommend you do is you watch all cutscenes in that mode. But only after you do that, and you complete that game, on your next playthrough, if you're going for a perfect playthrough, what I recommend you do is instead you skip all cutscenes. Because when you watch a cutscene, your timer goes... when a cutscene is playing, your timer is still going down. As you can see, I have the option to skip dialogues. By skipping dialogues, they go through quicker. Here's a pro tip. You see my sword's ready to bust, right? Well, guess what? Denise is one of my survivors that I'm escorting. She doesn't have a weapon. Give item. I could give her my sword, and guess what? My sword, despite being in a rough state, will not break in her hands. Same thing with weapons with ammo in it. If I have a gun with one bullet left, if I give it to a survivor, they could use it all the way to the safe house. Pharmacy key. Here's my Zombrex. Important to note, only Frank can pick up Zombrex. Chuck, if you're playing co-op, cannot. He could only indicate to Frank where it is. I need Zombrex by 8, which means I could take my Zombrex right now. If you're playing co-op, when you consume Zombrex, have Chuck take a picture of you consuming Zombrex. It gives a lot of PP to Chuck. Anyway, going to take some Zombrex. Whenever you take Zombrex, you obviously have to drop what's in your hand. Okay, as mentioned in the pharmacy, here's a coffee creamer, here's a orange juice, very good to have, and in the far end of the pharmacy is 1, 2, 3 bottles of juice and 1 coffee creamer. So in the pharmacy alone, you have 2 coffee creamers and 4 bottles of juice, all high-value items. Keep in mind, if you or your partner consume them quickly and you need more, you could always exit the level and re-enter the level in order to spawn more juice, spawn more items. Same thing goes for weapons, except for the LMG. The LMG is a great machine gun, which makes the game fairly easy. Unfortunately, it does not respawn, because I guess they figured the game would be too easy if it responded. Respawned. Okay. As you can see, Denise right now is running. Now I'm calling her. On PC, it's done with the Q key. It should be noted that I don't have an arrow to my safe house. I could always map an arrow. I don't recommend putting an arrow here. It gets a little sketchy. Maybe put an arrow right here. This is your safe house. What I can also do is, if ever I have a mission that goes to the safe house, I could select that. Now, as you can see, case 1-1 is a little tricky, but it's a good example. Right now it says nothing's happening, but Stacy will call me if something shows up, or something of that nature. I didn't really read it too well. It's important to keep note of these. Keep note of where they are. Because the way it's going to work is, for case 1-1, Stacy's going to call me sooner or later and say, Frank, you got to come to the safe house. But the problem is, the meter doesn't reset. So if I have but, like, 2 minutes left on the meter, I better be right next to that safe house. So keep in mind to be in the general vicinity of where a mission will take you. As you can see, I took an item here that chops. Items with blades, when you can't make your own items yet, are relatively good to have. Now, it's important that you can tell your survivors. When they're not on screen, you look at their little preview window. And if ever you see your survivor being choked, chances are you have to go rescue them. Survivors don't often get out of chokes, and if they're in a choke, they're going to perish. Also worth noting, if you hold the right mouse button and press the call button, wherever you're aiming, you're going to indicate to your survivor where to head. Now, this is extremely useful, especially if you have many survivors with you, and you're trying to get a mission complete. Because if your followers end up, following you all the time, and you're trying to save another survivor, and they're always perishing, maybe you want them to tell them to wait in a safe place, and then come get them only when you're ready to escort them. Okay, there we go. I got escort bonus, 10,000 PP. These are the case files. These missions must be completed. They are not negotiable. As you can see, I was offered to save and continue. What I would normally do is, if let's say I use slot 1, I would then save in slot 2, and so on and so forth. Then slot 3 for my next, and so on and so forth. Right now I'll overwrite my save, which you shouldn't do. I'm only doing it because my other save slots are full complete games, which I want to keep. Okay, so that being done, what will Sullivan tell me right now? Thank you. Here we go. He is going to give me the key to the maintenance room. Extremely important. Now that I have the maintenance room key, I could make weapons that are worthwhile. Essentially, you're combining two items together. Now, the first one you're going to be introduced to is the nail bat. The nail bat is fine. It's not bad. It's better than other combo weapons, but there's better weapons to be had. Thank you. What this is this is a combo card. There are two types of cards. There are combo cards and I forget what the other one's called. Anyway, when like a sketch card or something? Scratch card, thank you. Combo card, if you have the combo card, whenever you use the weapon, it will give you more experience when you use it to kill. Versus if you just make something on your own, it only gives one times the experience. Okay, so normally when you're coming down the hall, this is the first weapons locker you achieve. You go into here. An easy thing to make is you have a baseball bat on one side, you put it on the workbench, and the second is box of nails. Do 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 do. Look, I now have a bat with nails in it. Pretty cool. However, do I want that instead of a tomahawk? I'll keep it. Why not? Okay. Now you see this gentleman right here? He has a Bowie knife on him. Bowie knife is high value. Why is Bowie knife high value? Alone, is it so high value? Not so much. But when used with the boxing gloves, it makes the knife gloves, which is very high value. I'm going to put this right here. I'm going to pick up my bat again because I'm low on slots. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the boxing gloves. Now let me show you the path, the easiest way to get both Bowie knife and boxing gloves from your home base. In your home base, you're going to exit off to the left. On the left, you have the yesterday, today, and tomorrow newsstand. You're going to climb up to the top. And look what's up here, a Bowie knife, in case you didn't have one. I already put one on my workbench. And right across from it, the man's sport. There's boxing gloves in this window, there's boxing gloves in this window, and there's boxing gloves here. Gonna take a pair of boxing gloves. Here we go. Gotta make my way all the way back to my deal over here. Okay, Lashandra. Talk to you. Yes. You all right? Yes. Okay, we know. You better hit him, Lashandra. Will you? No? Okay. Very good. You gotta wait till you get has joined. Once you have has joined, you can call them over. My health is increased. Very good. And combo card. Weed tendonizer. So I could combine weed eater with a knife.